How you doing? My name is Thunder, welcoming you to part 3 of Out of Mona Lista, and yes, I could not help myself. I had to get a Dodge Viper for this, because... Viper. With, of course, the blue and white stripe scheme, because, you know, Viper, it just works great for the Viper. But anyways, let's not waste too much time with this. Let's get right into the action with the third level, where we have 5 stages this time. The Uraroko Hill Climb Challenge Cup at Rocko Hill, the Akagi Hill Climb Challenge Cup at Akagi Hill, the Loop Highway Challenge Cup 2 at Osaka Highway, the Urban Challenge Cup 2 at East Tokyo Fine, and the Rainy Street Challenge Cup 2 at East Tokyo Rain. So let's go for the easiest one, the Uraroko Hill Climb Challenge Cup, which is only 2 stars. I also finally got around to actually, putting on the thing, so it's, you know, the triggers now are accelerate and brake, and the face buttons are shift up and down, but let's see how I do with that change. Rocko Hill. Except this time, we're going up rather than down. I probably may have been better off putting on the acceleration one, because the Viper does have longer gears, but the Viper is also powerful. With the tuning parts that I have available at me at the time, this is already over, 550 horsepower, so we're looking at a pretty powerful machine. Just mostly only shifted up to third to calm the car down. Oh boy. Come on. Oh no. That was bad. Yeah, this kind of track's not exactly a Viper's territory, but if you're good enough with it, you can pull off something good, which is what I'm trying to go for here. I think after this, once we get to the Akagi Hill one later in this level, I'm going to try putting a more acceleration-based transmission on it to see if that helps the car any better. But we'll see. Needless to say right now, though, I think the good thing is that we're currently still winning with, you know, this car drifting around in its cell-shaded smoke, because everything is cell-shaded, and it's just a weird idea for a design look for the game, but I guess they decided, well, Jet Set Radio worked with this, let's try it with the car game, and unfortunately this game didn't exactly hit the mark, but it's not a bad game. I enjoy playing it, but... You know, there are certainly better racing games out there. Regardless, had a mostly worry-free run there, and we got the win. Minute 50 with this Viper, and that was going up the hill too. Anyways, let's move on. And now I got the level 3 engine tune-up. So we're getting all those engine level tune-ups. So let's go and quickly put that on. So let's go over tune-up, engine, and look at that, 613 horsepower. This is one powerful Viper now. So there we go. So now we got that done. Let's go over to the next race. Level 3. And the next one, and by difficulty, we can choose either the Loop Highway Challenge Cup 2 at Osaka Highway or the East Tokyo Rain. I'm going to go with the Loop Highway Challenge Cup 2 at Osaka Highway. Pretty much what we already did in level 1, except now there's actually a second lap this time. Let's go for max speed. And you know what? Because this is all tarmac, like highway tarmac, let's go for slicks. Just see how we do. But now that we got that stuff on, it's time to race. Osaka Highway. Alright, and here we go. Oops, I pressed the shift down button rather than the shift up button. My bad. Doesn't matter, because we're getting there. Because we're on slicks, this car should have the best grip possible. And it works for a track like this simply because this is, you know, like I said, it's all tarmac, so... Look at that, not even... This car is 6 gears, and we're hitting 200, over 200 in 5th gear. So it's like, yeah. And pretty much we just catch all the rest of these guys past the leading Corvette, and we're now in the lead. Nice. Oh my god. That was a big mistake. Especially since it cost us being in first place. Although there's 2 laps, so there's no big worry here. Alright, there we go. Getting it back together. And now just basically all pure high-speed adrenaline as it rushes through your veins. You can't help but want to take more of it inside. I should not do that voice. Coughing so hard it's making my eyes water. So yeah, this car... Oh, no! Oh! This is the worst track to have that happen on. Yeah, you can't really get any bump push. They kind of just slide off and just go over to the side like that. So simply like I just did right there. Oh no! Again! Come on, man. We gotta get this together. Okay, I'm definitely not doing these corners very well. That's for sure. Okay. And we're back in the lead. Okay, here's this section again. Oh! Oh! Ah, crap. Almost kept it completely off. But not completely. Anyways, let's just not worry about what happened because we're in the lead and that's what matters. Why did I shift up? Okay, everything's all fine now. Despite those couple screw-ups, we've still won the race. And that's probably one of the only times I'm going to be... Unless it's the oval track, I think I'm going to be sticking with slicks, so... Just because, yeah. You don't really need slicks anywhere else. Especially the next track, we're definitely not going to do it at all. Now we got a level 2 weight reduction. So that's some weight stripped off. And already we can go to level 4, but we're not gonna do that just yet. That'd be kind of stupid to do. Anyways, let's go and put that weight reduction on. Level 2, and we're down. How much was that? 104 pounds. Wow, that's quite a strip away. But I am okay with that. Anyways, let's go back to racing and. Let's, level 3. And next up, we're gonna have the East Tokyo Rainy Street Challenge Cup 2. Because it's also a three-star rated one. Before we start, we're gonna take these slicks off, give it the sports radials. And I'm also gonna adjust the gears, too, because we don't need all the high-end speed for this one. We just need at least... some acceleration would be nice, so let's do that. And away we go. Don't mind me if you hear anything in my mouth. I gotta take some Tums for my. How'd they get to reverse? Must have. Okay, that was an accident then. And poor start because of me done goofing it, but whatever. Oh no. Oh boy. Took me a second to realize this is the reverse. It's the other way around this time. Wow, those other cars, they really took off. Oh man. Come on. I want to catch up to them. This is actually kind of concerning, to be honest. I want to get up to them, and it just doesn't feel like I'm going to catch them. Especially because we did that. We'll see if I get lucky then. This is still only a 2-lapper, just like the first one. Okay, there's a third place car. So let's pass him by. Be careful. I keep messing the gears up. But We're in third place. I don't really care. Okay, that's... First gear was bad to do there. Okay. Alright. This is looking better. And goodbye. Because I can use this straight away to rely on the car's top end. SO and smack. Shift down to get the speed. And one more corner to go. And there we are. Actually, not too bad that time. So yeah, not as smooth as the Lancer, but we still got the win at the end, and that's what matters. Alright. Let's finish up that, and let's go next. And this time we get level 2 computer tuning, so pretty much more power. So let's just go quickly put that on. Because we can! Huzzah! Because nothing costs any money in this game. There is no currency. You just get the parts and then you can put them on. Easy as that. And now we hit 625 horsepower. Very nice. I think it really matters which brand you choose. It's just... I don't know. Does it matter? Or does it make a difference? I honestly don't know, to be honest. Alright, level 3. We're good. And let's do the Akagi Hill Climb Challenge. We're going to get a secret card for this one. Alright, and then... actually, no, I think this is already set for acceleration right now. Although, I'm going to make it even more so set for acceleration. Oh, wait, no, it's already set to that, to as much as it can. Okay, never mind. Just leave it so, because we really need it to be that way for a track like this. Let's just hope that it all goes well. Actually, wait a minute. Before I do that, let's try putting some slicks on for this track. Just see how we do. Probably would be a good idea. And okay, there we go. Let's go. Again, back into reverse gear. Huh, interesting. We got a Hyundai Accent rally car in the field. This isn't rally though. This is Toge. But yeah, yeah. Wow, this thing is a. Oh, I should not have spoken so suddenly. Okay, come on. Let's get this thing up past. Can we pass the R30? Oh, wow. We somehow managed to sneak in, but that's probably not a good time to do it there. Come on. Use the speed of the Viper to its advantage to pass to get up to that Accent. Oh, boy. Okay. Don't worry. We're in the lead now. That's the important bit. Oh. Oh dear. This isn't working out, to say the least. Again, this track just is not the Viper's territory, so... But needless to say, we seem to be doing a bit more comfortably now, so... I did not mean to shift up all the way like that. Okay. Oop, careful. Alright, there we go. Wow, I managed to still get to 150 on this track. This kind of track, of all places, to be able to reach that kind of speed. Yeah, I'm not complaining. That's pretty cool. Okay, and ease up, and gun it. Oh boy. Okay. Wow, we're actually quite well in the lead. We're at over 12-second lead there, 12 and a half. Like, I didn't expect to suddenly just pull away from the field like that. I mean, wow. I guess this Viper does have more tricks up its sleeve. Okay, that was a little crazy, but we're all right. Okay. And there we go. We made it up the hill in 2 minutes, 18.8 seconds. Very good. Very nice. Okay. So now we got that done. Let's go move on. And we got a Toyota 11 TE27. Not a car we're probably going to use, but it's there. Alright, now we got just one more to go, and this one's got a pretty hefty 6-star rating. East Tokyo Fine at the Urban Challenge Cup 2. Let's take a quick look at this. This is going to need a... Actually, no, this car still has a decent top end, even with an acceleration focus. So let's just leave it as is. Nothing to really worry about there. And let's go. Okay, East Tokyo Fine, yet again. Probably the other way this time, though. Yeah. One thing I kind of don't like is in the later levels, the cars in front, they just kind of get this super huge start. They just blaze off, and I don't think there's any way you can do such a thing. I'm really screwing it up, jeez. Come on, try not to keep that up. Just try to get more stable and have a better run. Alright. So far it seems to be working out. Pass by that Supra. Wow, I really had a hammer on the brakes there, but I think I did it just at the right time. Come on, we can catch up to those last two up there. Alright, I see them in my sights. That's good, because we still have another lap to go. If this was only one lap, this would have been pretty hard, to be honest. Past the other Viper, and a rather interesting car right here. You may not recognize it now, but the game will tell us later when we unlock it. At some point. Ooh. Yeah, I'd say we're still doing alright. Okay. And now we should be pretty set for the win here. As long as we don't do anything really stupid. Alright, there we go. And then another good timing for the brakes there. And to the finish we go. Bam. With the win. We're still got a perfect record here so far. I haven't had to redo any of these races so far. And that's been three whole levels. Yep. The Orochi from Mitsuoka. That's what it was. So let's go next. We win. We get a steering wheel. And we get a small championship cup, and as well as Shop Automodelista has been added to our inventory. So, you may probably be wondering what was that that just appeared. Actually, I don't know, to be honest. I don't know. I don't know where... Okay, never mind. Let's not worry about that. But... This was our little prize, and with Shop Automodelista, you can't do it with this car. It's basically an engine swap place. You can actually swap engines out of different cars, which, if it works for the car I have in mind that I'm going to do it with, should lead to a pretty interesting result, to say the least. But anyways, that's going to do it for part 3. Part 4 is actually going to be a little bit of a championship going on, because it seems to be that the 5 listed there are 2 races each. So that should be pretty interesting. So we'll have 10 races in that level alone. But anyways, guys, thank you for watching, and as always, take care.